Hello there, I am Ariana CP Hunter, real estate broker for Su Casa, Su Castillo. And today we're going to be talking about, well, what is the proper age or what is a good age to be a property owner or to buy your home, right? And the answer is going to be, well, it depends. If you're a stable young person, meaning that you are in the same job for more than 4 years and your job is pays a decent wage, it's not low income, but a medium income, something average, you are able to buy a property because you have to consider that as a young person, you don't have as much debt as older people, and that's a benefit. And many people think that, well, I won't afford much. Well, this is true. That's true. You probably won't afford much, but yet you could still purchase something. And most people don't consider the option of buying a condominium or a townhome to start. You could buy it with somebody else, with a roommate, or you could buy it with another person. It doesn't have to be a loved one or significant other. It could be just another person who wants to own property as well and cannot afford more property on their own, a friend of yours, perhaps. And that way you both could afford more housing. But if you could afford it on yourself, by yourself, alone, without anyone, then I suggest you do so. That many people think, well, I don't want to be locked in. I don't want to be landlocked. I want to follow my job. I don't want to be committed. Well, that is not a problem. You could leave your house rented, your condominium rented out while you move to follow your job. Or if you feel that need to sell, then you go ahead and sell. And that's not a problem. Remember, you still need to live somewhere. And every time you throw in your money away when you're renting, you're never going to see the money again. At least with a mortgage, you pay into that property the day that you decide to do whatever, you're going to probably get that money back, okay? So you could rent it, you could sell it. So that is not an excuse, really, that you don't want to be committed, because that's the number one reason people say, well, I want to wait. And then that's something you have to consider. For the people, and this is for the people who are young and want to buy, because I was young once and I wanted to buy my property young, and I bought my property, my first one at 23, and I bought a brand new home, and people they used to think I was crazy, really, because they were much older than I was, and they were not homeowners, but I didn't care. I knew I could buy. I saw the numbers. And at that time, I was very fortunate to find it, but I moved far away from my parents at that time to be able to buy. It doesn't matter. I would have taken any property that I could afford because I wanted to be an owner. So the point is, look, if you want to own your property, you don't have to wait past a certain age. You don't have to wait until you graduate from college. In fact, you shouldn't. Because what happens is more than people end up with more debt when they finish school. And so you are not even able to buy a property. And this is a big problem nowadays. So buy something small, something you could afford. And once you graduate, then you could sell it and buy something else and when you make more money. But in this day and age, really is really unpredictable. Education is wonderful. It's very costly, though. And there's a lot of people who, a lot of working people who do not have a college degree and make good money, okay? So don't let all these excuses be in the way of purchasing a home. Now, if you're young and you're like, well, I don't want something grown up. Well, you don't have to have something grown up. There's a lot of properties that are not grown up. You're not going to be living, let's say, in a neighborhood full of children, in young families. You could be living in a high-rise building with younger people or working professionals. So really, it's something that you have to look into. But maybe people are thinking, when I'm going to buy a property, a family, I'm going to be settling down. And that's not the case. There's a lot of young men, a lot of young women who buy properties, and they are owners of the property, and they have roommates. They rent out rooms, and that's how they pay. And it's a four-bedroom house. So there's many ways of going about it. I'm just saying, if you are stable, and that's what the bank looks for, okay? The bank looks for 2 years of the same consistency of income, but they're also going to see your debt. So if you're young right now and you don't have student loan, that's a good thing. As long as you don't have, you have credit cards, at least two or three to establish your credit, the bank will give you a property. So my advice, and it changes, of course, because it's based on everybody individually, circumstances, But buy your home. Don't wait. You don't have to wait. Those excuses are no excuses at all. You could always sell it. You could rent it. You could sell it and buy something bigger when you qualify for more. I hope this has helped you. Till next time.